Germany.
Hola.
Welcome back, everybody. We haven't uploaded in a while since it was Christmas and we were mostly away.
Bueno, pues hoy traemos Giantic, un modo en beta disponible para Windows 10 y Xbox One, y según dicen los desarrolladores, tendrá un lanzador externo a Windows Store para los demás sistemas operativos.
We have been playing this for a month or so, and now we're quite addicted to it. It is original enough, although not very extant, with only 16 characters and 3 maps in release, which isn't all that bad, really.
Aquí podéis ver los personajes que hay, cada uno es interesante a su manera. Tienen un aspecto o aspectos y variaciones de colores de cada uno, además de distintas armas. Todo cambio es únicamente visual, y se compra con gemas que te dan al completar ciertos objetivos en el juego.
Now we're going to be playing through a tutorial and explaining how things work along the way. As you can see, they allow you to choose any skin just for this time.
Lairin gains power as we defeat enemies and control the battlefield. When she has enough power to rampage, we must attack with her. The first guardian to reach full power attacks. It's our job to make sure Lairin gets power before Gren.
Aquí se muestra cómo subir las habilidades. Pero nosotros siempre usamos el botón control para ver con detalle qué hace la mejora de la vida en concreto.
Let's get it done. Follow me.
Hay muchas combinaciones para cada habilidad, como podéis ver, además de una pasiva con sus respectivas combinaciones.
Upgrade here.
Y una especialización que solo se sube con el juego partido.
Movement is a very important mechanic in Gigantic, for most abilities, including basic attacks, are skill shots and therefore dodgeable. There is a stamina, which is spent by many things such as running, jumping, dodging, and some abilities. Although not having Eldeth will not stop you from using abilities, it will stop you from doing the rest.
Por todo el mapa hay unos círculos de poder en los que puedes invocar criaturas que recojan dicho poder por ti.
We should summon creatures on our power circles to secure them. Keep in mind, it's best to stay close while the summon is in progress. The more heroes nearby, the faster it completes.
Hay que aclarar que si no invocas a ninguna criatura, la energía no se recogerá y al final la acabarás perdiendo.
Controlling the battlefield helps Lairin gain power, but we shouldn't try to hold the whole map. We should summon creatures on our power circles to secure them.
There are 3 types of power circles: your own, the enemies, and the neutral ones. And with only one exception, creatures can only be summoned in your own circles.
Summoning!
And remember, if the creature dies, that's a kill for the enemy, which gives them power. Don't summon a creature you can't defend.
Technically, it's 2 kills. When you defeat an enemy creature, you gain 2 kills worth of energy.
Lairin will show us when and where we can channel power to her.
Aunque el mapa te enseñe que hay energía en un círculo, no hay que preocuparse porque la criatura invocada en ese círculo la recogerá automáticamente a no ser que la interrumpan. El combate es bastante intuitivo, es de acción RPG y estratégico. Aunque en el tutorial es muy simple, luego veréis que no lo es tanto a la hora de jugar online.
Side of the battlefield. We can also summon creatures to gather power for us.
As you can see, if there isn't any creature to collect, you may have to do it yourself. As well as stealing the enemies if they haven't got one.
Upgrade here.
Creatures can be upgraded only once using focus charges. which are obtained by dealing damage to anything and sacrificed to upgrade the creatures. Be aware, creatures are defenseless and incapable of collecting energy during summoning.
Si no gastas las cargas de concentración en mejorar a las criaturas, siempre puedes usarlas en los ults. Acumular las cargas hasta un máximo de 3 conlleva que al usar tu ult gaste todas para un efecto más poderoso. Cada familia de criaturas comparte un efecto en el mapa, como la curación de los bloomers. En cambio, cada miembro de la familia tiene diferentes habilidades de combate. En el caso del único bloomer actualmente disponible, lanzar unas raíces que aturden.
The Cerberus family gives vision over a small portion of the map. This one fights with fire. Also, the Cerberus is the only family with more than one member currently. As well as vision, the Shadow Cerberus fights with teleports and it's in general stronger, but it costs 2 focus charges. The Cyclops costs 2 to upgrade as well, but they are the tankiest of them all. They stun in a small area when attacked. Their environmental impact summons a wall in certain places nearby that only allies can get through.
Each enemy you defeat grants me more strength.
Los dragones también cuestan 2 cargas mejorarlos y básicamente te atacan con fuego. Lanzan aleatoriamente fuego alrededor de ellos mismos en una pequeña área. El antiguo obelisco. Un momento, esto no es un obelisco, esto es el tótem. Como iba diciendo, el tótem es una familia de criaturas muy única, ya que puede ser invocada en los círculos de poder neutrales y enemigos, evitando que ellos puedan hacerse con su propio poder. Además, matar al tótem no da poder, así que no hay por qué no invocarlo.
This is the combat from the tutorial, which is some headbutt stupidity. Normally, combat has a deep strategy-based system that requires teamwork and communication. Of sorts, since the Xbox app sucks and there is no in-game chat. Find a friend to play if you want to do any good. Here you have some footage to lay your eyes upon.
Ahora vamos con la carrera de energía. Tu objetivo es obtener 100 de energía para que tu guardián pueda atacar al guardián enemigo y exponer su gema. Si consigues bajarle toda la barra de vida al guardián enemigo, le habrás herido.
We have accomplished our objective. Lairin has reached full power. She will expose Gren's life gem and keep him pinned as long as her power holds out.
Para ganar la partida tienes que herir al guardián 3 veces.
strike the life gem.
A diferencia del tutorial, que es más fácil, en las partidas online hay que atacar en equipo. Cada baja que el equipo atacante consiga durante la fase de ataque, aumenta la duración de dicha fase. En cambio, si es el equipo defensor quien consigue bajas, el escudo de su guardián aumenta.
Sometimes you'll get some scrubs as teammates, and therefore it'll be your turn to defend your guardian. If you manage to defend it past the attack phase, the injury will not be done, and its health will remain the same until the next attack. Once all two remaining injuries have been made, the team to deal the third first will have achieved victory.
Bueno chicos,
that'll be all for the tutorial.
Pronto lo haremos con un gameplay de este juego.
Although we might also make an extended tutorial for a deeper look at mechanics and tactics such as
mover a personajes invisibles,
the fact that you cannot damage guardians from too far away,
o que puedes matar enemigos tirándoles al vacío. Y muchas otras cosas.
See you soon, lads.
Adiós. Hola.
Hola.
Ay, Dios.
Has borrado.
¿Qué he hecho?
Has borrado.
¿Cómo empieza? Empieza, tiene sentido que digamos hola y tú buscas. Sí.
Es el Sunin.
Sí.
Sunin.
Hi.
Hi. Hola.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back, fucking idiots. What else is
I'm joking.